Hey everyone, it's Nick Valenti with NJ Valenti Art, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to easily mirror your vector line art in Affinity Designer. So I've got my vector tiger face here, and what I've done is I've broken it up into a few different layers. I've got the whiskers separate from our main outline, also separate from all the details that we have in the tiger's face itself. And as you can see, what I do when I'm working on the vector line art is I will vector half of the drawing, leaving the other half unfinished. And now I'm going to show you how to go ahead and flip these vector lines and mirror them perfectly to the other side. Now I want to show you this a few times, the way we could cover a few different things. But what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to come down here to the main outline layer. And with that layer selected, I've got my move tool, V, selected. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hold down Alt, and holding Alt while dragging will duplicate my selection. Now while I'm holding Alt, I also want to hold down Shift, which will keep my selection in line. So we'll go ahead and hold Alt and Shift and simply drag over to the right of our canvas. Once I get to about here, I'll come up here to the top bar, and where it says Flip Horizontal, I'll go ahead and click that, and you can see it's now flipped our line art. I'll continue holding Shift, dragging this over until I feel like it's about lined up, and then I'll come in here and I'll take a closer look. Still holding Shift, I can hold and pull that line out a little bit further. Holding the space bar, I'll get rid of the selection outline to get a better look at what I'm doing. And when you're mirroring your vector lines, you'll oftentimes have these little tiny artifacts here where the corners will kind of not line up perfectly. So we can continue to kind of try to line those up. That works pretty good. And now we'll want to come down the illustration and double check any of our other connecting points. See down here? They didn't quite connect. So what we could do is we'll just simply select our node tool, A. I'll select this line and I'll bring these nodes a little bit closer to each other. This side as well. Now, these pieces here can get a little finicky. So one way that we could take care of those without having to get too concerned with lining them up perfectly is once we've got everything lined up pretty good, we'll take our move tool again. I'll select both of the outline shapes. I'll come back up here to our top bar and click Add. That'll now combine both shapes together. And then I can simply come in here with my node A tool again, select the node that I don't want, and delete it. Sometimes it may trim it up too much, so you could always just place that node over the other node. And now we'll come back up top and see how we did up here. I'll go ahead and combine these two as well. And now, using my A node tool, I can get rid of a few of these extra nodes here, and I've cleaned up that line. Okay? Now, by selecting the whole layer and duplicating it to the other side, you can see it's created, obviously, two different layers here. So what we can do is we can go ahead and open one of them up and grab all the curves from that one and simply drag them into our other side. That way, we have one layer for our main outline. Now I'm going to work on mirroring the rest of the drawing. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to lock our main outline layer as well as the whiskers. And I want to show, if you come into the details here, now as opposed to selecting just the layer itself, if I come in with our move tool and simply make a selection, dragging our cursor there, it'll select all the curves within that layer. I'm going to hold Alt and Shift once again, hitting the Flip Horizontal at our top menu bar, continuing to hold Shift to keep everything in line. And double checking our connecting points, and just want to take a quick look and see where we might have to come back and do some adjustments. All right, but that's all looking pretty good. You can also use your arrow keys with everything selected. Might bring these just a little bit closer together. But that'll be pretty good for now. I'm going to go ahead and speed up the cleanup process here just a little bit. So the cleanup process can take a little bit of time, but it's certainly worth it. It'll keep your image a little more consistent and more professional. We'll go ahead and do the whiskers as well now. So I'm just going to come into our whiskers layer. I've got our move tool selected. I'm going to go ahead and select all of those whiskers once again. Again, holding Alt to duplicate and Shift to keep in line. I'm going to drag that to the right of our canvas. I'm going to come right up here and click Flip Horizontal again. Holding Shift, I'm going to line these whiskers up on the other side. And there you go. We turn off our drawing layer. Now we've got just our vector lines. So that's how you can quickly and easily mirror your vector lines in Affinity Designer. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. Please like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. I'm working on new how to draw and paint videos, so if you have something you need help with, let me know in the comments. Keep chasing your dreams, and until next time.